Hi there, rock stars. It's Meredith, and I hope you are finishing out an amazing November and ready to launch into your most powerful December yet. So today, I want to debunk a little bit of, I think, the misconception around the concept of gratitude. I think it's almost been used to the point where it's becoming a cliche, a little bit woo-woo, and almost like one of those old rabbit feet that people used to carry around for superstition, thinking that if I carry my rabbit foot, if I have my lucky sweater, or if I have my lucky this, that good things are going to happen. And gratitude is much more powerful than that. Gratitude, when properly used, is really more accurately called a deliberate focus, and deliberately focusing on the places that you want to go, the things that you want to experience, the things, some of which you may already have and which you feel grateful for, and some of them may yet to be. You can still feel grateful for that feeling when you have abundance if you're not a multi-gazillionaire. Maybe there was one moment that you can remember, even as a child, when someone gave you a $5 bill, or maybe as an adult, you got a check, a refund back that you totally weren't expecting. And for that moment, you were like, wow, that's a moment of feeling abundance that you can feel grateful for. And what it's like is that when you are grateful for that, when you focus in on that, when you hone on that, you are programming your reticular activation system, your subconscious, your own personal life GPS as one of the destination points that you want to visit. So let's get into the realm now of authenticity with gratitude. Is it authentic to talk about something that's not perfect, I hate to use the word to pretend. There's a big difference between pretending, because when you're pretending, that means that you actually, the energy that you're investing, the story that you're actually creating, is that this is the land of make-believe, that this will not ever be true, that we're not evolving in that direction. And yet, for this purposes, for our purposes here, what really is more accurate is the analogy of, let's say that you're saving up for something big. You're saving up for a trip to the Himalayas, right? And it's going to take a huge investment to get there. And you're just starting that, but you've identified that as a place that you want to be going. So isn't it genuine and authentic today to say that the money that you're earning, the work that you're doing, a portion of that, the whole reason, its purpose is accurately and realistically for that trip? So this money, even though you're not in the Himalayas yet, and you've never ever been to the Himalayas, it's realistic to say, that's where I'm going. I'm working now, and that's where I'm going. That's my goal. That's my target. I intend to make it there. And that's a whole different mindset than just saying, I've just got this bunch of money. I'm working and I don't really have a purpose for it. It's all of a sudden it becomes just solely about this little box that is now. And our lives are not just solely about what is now. And that's where we trip up a lot of times. We get so focused on the little sticky spot that we're working through, the big challenge. We may have one big challenge in one area of our life that makes us, for some reason, totally discount a lot of the things that are really rocking and rolling. It's like, well, yeah, I mean, I'm happy, but, and the stuff that comes before the but, that's why but can be such a dangerous word. The stuff that comes before the the but, you're not giving any energy to, you're not feeding, you're not putting gas in that tank. And it's critical, because that's the, where you're putting your gas, where you're putting your focus, where you're putting your energy is the only way that, whether you want to call it life, whether you want to call it God, whether you want to call it your reticular activation system, your subconscious, it's the only way that knows where to go. So going back to the GPS analogy, let's say you do want to go to the Himalayas. So you put that in your GPS. And then, though, you really don't want to go to Chicago, and yet you're focusing on it. So you said, let's look at it. So you program that into the GPS. Because you really want, you want more sticky details about, look, oh yeah, that's really why I don't want to go there. Look at the traffic. It's terrible. It's all backed up. Look at all the red spots on there. I really don't want to go there. Well, your poor GPS now has Himalayas and Chicago, and to it, it's 6 1/2 a day. It doesn't know where you want to go. So that's where the gratitude comes in. So for the, anything that you want to show up more in your life must be fed. It must get the gas in its tank. It must get the rocket fuel. It must get the focus. It must get the energy. And a very, very powerful way to do that is in those gratitude sort of moments where you sit down and you dedicate, understanding how powerful it is that this is the gas. I mean, we technically, when we're going on a trip, it stops the momentum when we stop to put gas in the car. But we all know that if we say, hey, I don't want to stop, I just want to drive for 13 hours, I'm not stopping at a gas station. Well, at some point, the gas is going to run out and we're going nowhere. And that really, really, really is why it's so important that this perfect time right after Thanksgiving, going into the end of the year, that you really go back and give yourself credit, celebrate how far you've come, celebrate even the things that were rough, and even the ones that now at least you have the clarity to say, I'm not choosing that again. Thank you. I tried it, and I won't always be wondering what would have been like if I did choose it. Okay, I chose it, and now, whew, great. This is part of the fun. This is creating the masterpiece, right? Getting our hands deliciously in the paint and covered with paint, faces, smocks, everything. So it's really, really important that you celebrate the aspects of yourself that have been powerful aspects that have helped you overcome things that maybe when you were in the flux of it, you didn't even know if you would make it through. And yet you did. And that is something to be celebrated, not to be something as compartmentalized as having a damaged or flawed or labeled something other than great. And as you move into December, dare to dream, dare to push that GPS farther than you've ever gone, even if it leaves the planet. Believe that you have the capability, you have everything inside of you that you need. It's just simply a matter of continuing to specifically understand that you need to choose what buttons you press on your GPS, and you need to choose where you put your energy, and you need to choose to dedicate the time to gas up that tank. That's super, super important, because no tank, even the most expensive car, cannot run without some sort of energy. So that's our little thought today as you move about and make sure that the things that you're playing with right now, that you may be labeling your challenges, great, but don't let them get out of perspective. They're temporary. They're something that ultimately will lead to someplace great, some wonderful clarity, some wonderful revelation, and maybe creating something entirely brilliant and new, and something that you look back on your life and go, wow, if I hadn't had those moments of doom and gloom, I wouldn't be where I am today. You're rocking the house, and just love what you're doing. Love this day, love this opportunity, and just love part of this experience, and really enjoy being part of this process. So I'm Meridith, saying make it a rock star day, rock star weekend. Until we talk next, sky is the limit. All right. Love you guys. Back to you soon. Bye.